हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ रचना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कम्युनिटी हेल्थ नर्सिंग इन मेट्रो कॉलेज ऑफ नर्सिंग। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट पोस्टपार्टम विजिट्स बाय हेल्थ वर्कर एट होम और एट हेल्थ सेंटर और इन कम्युनिटी। ओके, सो दिस इज़ द न्यूली एडेड टॉपिक इन योर सिलेबस इन कम्युनिटी हेल्थ नर्सिंग एज अ कम्युनिटी हेल्थ ऑफिसर। सो रिगार्डिंग इंट्रोडक्शन, वॉट इज पोस्टपार्टम केयर? द केयर गिवन ड्यूरिंग द पोस्टपार्टम पीरियड इज कॉल्ड एज पोस्टपार्टम केयर। सो वॉट इज पोस्टपार्टम पीरियड? फर्स्ट 42 डेज और 6 वीक्स आफ्टर डिलीवरी आर कंसिडर्ड एज द पोस्टपार्टम पीरियड। 60% ऑफ मेटरनल डेथ्स टेक प्लेस ड्यूरिंग द पोस्टपार्टम पीरियड। The first 48 hours of the postpartum period followed by the first week are the most crucial period for the health and survival both of the mother and her newborn. Okay, the most of the fatal and near fatal maternal and neonatal complications occur during the first 48 hours and first week of this period. So this postpartum care is very important as this period is very crucial for both mother and the baby. So these are the number and timings of postpartum visits by A&M or ASHA or any health care provider in community. So after delivery at home or sub center, the first visit is done on first day within 24 hours. The second visit at third day after delivery, third visit on seventh day after delivery, fourth visit after 6 weeks of delivery. Then if the delivery is at PHC or first referral unit, the first visit that is within 24 hours, the mother is attended by the hospital staff only. Then second visit is done on third day after delivery, third visit is done on seventh day after delivery, fourth visit is done on 6 weeks after delivery. If there is any additional visits for low birth weight babies, it is to be done on day 14th, 21st and 28th after delivery. So during first postpartum visit or during within 24 hours, what will you do in for the postpartum care of mother? Firstly, you will take the history. In that, review the events at labor and birth to identify any risk factor or significant events during the birth that may be important in the management of the mother and the baby. Ask the following questions to the mother: where did the delivery take place? Who conducted the delivery? Take the history for any complications or following problems during the delivery and now. Has the mother started breastfeeding the baby? Has she started her regular diet? Are there any other complaints? In examination, what will you examine? Firstly, check the mother's or women's pulse, blood pressure, temperature and respiratory rate. Then check the conjunctiva for pallor. Conduct an abdominal examination, check the uterus, examine the vulva and perineum for any presence of tears or tear, swelling or pus discharge, examine the pad for bleeding to assess if the bleeding is heavy and also see whether the lochia is foul smelling, or you can say if there is any risk of purpureal sepsis or infection. Examine the breast for any lumps or tenderness. Check the conditions of the nipple. In following conditions, you will refer the mother or woman to the referral unit during your first postpartum visit, that is within 24 hours. If you see the uterus is soft or tender, you will refer her. If you see heavy bleeding, tears, pus discharge, foul smelling lochia while examining the vulva and perineum, you will refer her. Then in breast conditions, if there is any sore nipples, abscess or any feeding problems, you will refer her to the referral unit. these are the danger signs in which you have to refer the women or mother to the referral unit during your first postpartum visit. If there is any excessive bleeding, that is soaking more than 2-3 pads in 20 to 30 minutes after delivery. If there is any convulsions, fever, severe abdominal pain, difficulty in breathing, foul smelling lochia, then refer the mother to the referral unit. Also, in management or counseling, you will give the woman and her family the following advice. First, postpartum care and hygiene. She should have someone near her for the first 24 hours to take care of her and the baby. She should wash the perineum daily and after passing urine and stools. The perineal pads must be changed every 4 to 6 hours or more frequently if they are soaked to avoid infection. Cloth pads should be washed with soap and water and dried in the sun. Use of disposable sanitary pads is preferred as they can be discarded when soaked. She should bathe daily. She should take enough rest and sleep. She should wash her hands before and after handling the baby, especially after cleaning and before feeding the baby. Rooming in of the mother and with the baby is advisable. You can advise her to room in with the baby. Then advise the mother on how to look after her newborn. For example, how to bathe the newborn, maintain warmth and exclusive breastfeeding. Regarding nutrition, what will you advise? She should increase her intake of food, dal, roti or rice, green leafy and other vegetables, fruits, milk and curd, and other fluids available at home. Advise her to refrain from observing taboos that exist in the community against nutritionally healthy foods. For example, the taboo against eating solid foods for first 6 days after delivery. जो हमारी local community में है वहाँ ये practice की जाती है, ये practice follow की जाती है कि after delivery first 6 days solid food नहीं दिया जाता है mother को खाने के लिए. तो अगर ये सॉलिड फूड न्यूट्रिशनली हेल्दी फूड में आता है तो इस टैबू को रिमूव करना है वहाँ से, कि आप न्यूट्रिशनली हेल्दी फूड, चाहे वो सॉलिड है चाहे वो लिक्विड है, वो ले सकते हैं. ओके, उसके बाद है टॉक टू द वुमेन्स फैमिली मेम्बर, हर हस्बैंड एंड मदर इन लॉ, टू एनकरेज देम टू इंश्योर दैट शी ईट्स इनफ एंड अवॉइड्स एनी हैवी फिजिकल वर्क. रिगार्डिंग कॉन्ट्रासेप्शन, advise the couple regarding the return of fertility. Advise the couple on contraception as per their needs for birth spacing or limiting the family. Advise the couple to abstain from sexual intercourse for about 6 weeks postpartum or till the perineal wounds heal and the woman is comfortable. Regarding breastfeeding, ask the mother whether breastfeeding was initiated within 1 hour of the birth. If breastfeeding is still not initiated, then assist her in breastfeeding the baby immediately. Okay, observe the breastfeeding and check if there is good attachment and effective suckling. Advise her to feed the baby colostrum. Colostrum is the first initial milk after delivery. Ask her to breastfeed in a relaxed environment, free from any mental stress. These are the signs of good attachment of the baby to the mother's breast. There are 4 signs. First is chin touching breast or very close. Then mouth wide open. Lower lip turned outward. More areola visible above than below the mouth. Upar ki taraf jo hai areola visible jyada hoga. Niche wala areola jo lower lip se wo cover ho jayega to below the माउथ जो है एरियोला कम विजिबल होगा. देन स्ट्रेस फॉर एक्सक्लूसिव ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग, उनको बताना है व्हाट इज़ द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ एक्सक्लूसिव ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग और एक्सक्लूसिव ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग EBF होता क्या है. एंड ऑल्सो स्ट्रेस फॉर डिमांड फीडिंग. वेन एवर द बेबी डिमांड्स शी शुड फीड हर और हिम. ओके, शी शुड ब्रेस्ट फीड फ्रॉम बोथ ब्रेस्ट ड्यूरिंग ए फीड. द बेबी शुड फिनिश एम्प्टिंग वन ब्रेस्ट टू गेट द रिच हाइंड मिल्क बिफोर स्टार्टिंग ऑन द सेकेंड ब्रेस्ट. पहले एक ब्रेस्ट का मिल्क पूरी तरह एम्प्टी हो जाना चाहिए, उसके बाद ही सेकेंड ब्रेस्ट स्टार्ट करना है. ठीक है, डेमोन्स्ट्रेट हाउ टू बर्प द बेबी आफ्टर फीड्स. टेल अबाउट इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस, इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ बर्पिंग. देन देयर मे बी सम ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग प्रॉब्लम्स, देन इन दैट केस वट विल यू एडवाइज हर. इन केस ऑफ डिफिकल्टी इन फीडिंग टीच हर करेक्ट पोजिशन फॉर फीडिंग. इफ़ देर इज़ एनी क्रैक्ड और सोर निप्पल्स अप्लाई हाइंड ब्रेस्ट मिल्क ऑन द क्रैक, इंश्योर गुड अटैचमेंट. If the discomfort continues, feed expressed breast milk with a clean spoon from a clean bowl. If there is any engorged breast, let the baby continue to suck and apply cold compress. If there is any breast abscess, feed from the unaffected breast and refer the mother to the first referral unit. Then also advise her regarding registration of birth. Explain the importance of getting the birth of the baby registered with local panchayat or health center. Then iron folic acid supplementation. She should take one iron folic acid tablet daily for 3 months. If she was anemic prior to delivery, recheck her hemoglobin level. If hemoglobin level is less than 11 grams per deciliter, then advise her to take 2 iron folic acid tablets daily for 3 months, and if after 1 month her hemoglobin level has not improved, refer her to PHC. If hemoglobin level is less than 7 grams per deciliter, refer her to first referral unit. Then regarding baby care during your first postpartum visit, firstly you will take the history. In that you will ask the mother, when did the child pass urine and meconium? Has the mother started breastfeeding the baby and are there any difficulties in breastfeeding? You will ask her. Then is there a newborn history of problems such as following? Ask the mother regarding the newborn history, if there is any fever, if the baby is not suckling well, then there may be any ulcers or white patches in the mouth, you can call them thrush. Then if there is any difficulty in breathing, the umbilical cord is red or swollen, or is there any discharging pus, the movements of the newborn are less than normal, if any, then there is skin infection, or you can say pustules. These are the red spots which contain pus or a big boil. If there is any convulsion, and also ask for any other complaints. Also ask her about Apgar score at the time of birth. Then examination of the baby. In that you will count the respiratory rate for 1 minute. Look for severe chest in drawing. Check the baby's color. Check for pallor. Check for jaundice. Check for central cyanosis. You will check the tongue and lips for any blue color. Then check the baby's body temperature. Examine the umbilicus for any bleeding, redness or pus. Examine for skin infection. Examine the newborn for cry and activity. Examine the eyes for discharge. Check if there are red or if the eyelids are swollen. Examine for congenital malformations and any birth injury. Then regarding advices or management or counseling, give the mother the following advice. She should maintain hygiene while handling the baby. She should delay the baby's first bath to beyond 24 hours after birth. The baby must be kept warm all the times. In cool weather, the baby's head and feet should be covered and he or she should be dressed in extra clothing. Then she should not apply anything on the cord and must keep the umbilicus and cord dry. counsel the mother on where and when to take the baby for immunization. Tell her about immunization schedules also, and importance of immunization for the baby. Then, if the baby is having the following problems, take him or her immediately to the medical officer at the first referral unit. Ask the mother about the if there is any problems, like if the baby is not breastfeeding, the baby looks sick, lethargic or irritable, the baby has fever or feels cold to the touch, breathing is fast or difficult, there is any blood in the stools, the baby looks yellow, pale or bluish, the baby's body is arched forward, the movement of the body, limbs or face are irregular, the umbilicus is red, swollen and draining pus, the baby has not passed meconium within 24 hours of birth, or if there is any diarrhea. Now, about second and third visits. During your second and third postpartum visit, what will you do for the postpartum care for mother? In that, firstly, you will take the history taking. When you go for the second and third visit, how will you take the history? What all things are required in history taking? A similar history needs to be taken as during the first visit. Apart from the questions asked during the first visit, also ask the mother the following. Okay, these are the added on questions that you have to ask during your second and third visits to the mother. Is there continued bleeding per vagina? This, that is postpartum bleeding occurring 24 hours or more after delivery, is known as delayed PPH, postpartum hemorrhage. So second and third visit is done on third and seventh day of the delivery. So in that you will ask, is there any foul smelling vaginal discharge? This could be indicative of puerperal sepsis. Has there been any fever? Is there a history of swelling or engorgement or tenderness of the breast? Is there any pain or problem while passing urine, dribbling or leaking? So, is there any fatigue, or is she not feeling well? Does she feel unhappy or cry easily? Are there any other complaints? Okay, there may be some postpartum depression or blues. Okay, then in examination of second and third visits, what will you examine? This is similar to the examination conducted during the first visit. It includes the following: check the pulse, BP and temperature, check the conjunctiva for pallor, conduct an abdominal examination, check the uterus, examine the vulva and perineum for the presence of any tear or swelling or pus discharge, examine the pad for bleeding to assess if the bleeding is heavy, and also see whether the lochia is foul smelling, if there is any risk of puerperal sepsis. Then examine the breast for any lumps or tenderness, check the condition of the nipple. Refer her to the first referral unit if there are any problem. Then you will counsel her or give her advices regarding diet and rest, contraception and breastfeeding. Regarding baby, during second and third visits, in history taking, the same question should be asked during history taking as during the first postpartum visits. So history taking will be the same. In examination, observe the baby and record the following: whether he or she is suckling well, if there is difficulty in breathing, fast or slow breathing, and any chest indrawing, if there is fever or the baby is cold to touch, if there is jaundice, you can check his or her palms and soles for any yellowishness. Then whether the cord is swollen or there is discharge from it, any pus. If the baby has diarrhea with blood in the stool, if there are convulsions or arcing of the baby's body, refer the baby to the PHC or first referral unit if any of the above complaint is present. Regarding management or counseling of the baby, in addition to the lines along with counseling was provided during the first visit, reinforce the following points. She should exclusively breastfeed the baby for 6 months. She should feed the baby on demand. Then she should be encouraged to rumen. Supplementary foods should be introduced at the age of 6 months. After 6 months, then she can continue breastfeeding simultaneously along with that. Then also talk to the mother about the following. Baby's weight loss. The baby loses a little weight in the first 3 days after birth. This is a normal process and the mother should not worry about it. After the third day, the baby starts gaining weight and regains its birth weight by the first week of delivery. Then regarding hygiene of the baby, healthcare provider should counsel the mother. While bathing the baby, special attention should be paid to the head, face, skin flexures, cord and napkin area. These should be dried properly with soft cloth. What is skin flexure? Skin flexures वो होते हैं जो जब आप कोई भी joint को flexion करते हैं तो वो वाले joint पे जो skin होती है, ठीक है, जो folds होते हैं, skin folds, उनको कहते हैं हम skin flexures. Then immunization, the baby should be immunized as per universal immunization program. You should advise her, you should tell her about the importance of immunization, timings, schedule, okay. Then fourth postpartum visit for mother. Regarding that, what history will take? Ask the mother the following. Has the vaginal bleeding stopped? Has her menstrual cycle resumed? Is there any foul smelling or vaginal discharge? Does she have any pain or problem while passing urine, dribbling or leaking? If it is present, then there may be chances of UTI. Okay. Does she get easily fatigued or does not feel well? Is she having any problem with breastfeeding? Are there any other complaints? In examination of mother during fourth postpartum visit, it includes the following. Check the women's BP, check for pallor, examine the vulva and perineum for the presence of any swelling or pus, examine the breast for the presence of lumps or tenderness. If either is present, refer her to the medical officer. Then regarding management or counseling, what will you advise? Advise her regarding diet and rest. As in the second and third visit, emphasize the importance of nutrition in contraception. Emphasize the importance of using contraceptive methods for spacing or limiting the size of the family. During the fourth visit, fourth postpartum visit, what will you do for the baby care? Firstly, history taking. Ask the mother the following. Has the baby received all the vaccines recommended so far? Is the baby taking breastfeeds well? How much weight has the baby gained? You can weigh the baby also. Does the baby have any kind of problem? In examination, check the weight of the baby. Check if the baby is active or lethargic. Check the baby's movements. Then regarding management and counseling, tell the mother what is good for baby during the fourth visit of your postpartum visits. Firstly, emphasize the importance of exclusive breastfeeding. Tell the mother that if the baby is having any of the following problems, she should be taken immediately to the medical officer at the first referral unit. The baby is if the baby is not accepting breastfeed, if he or she looks sick, lethargic or irritable, if the baby has fever or feels cold to the touch, if the baby has convulsions, if the breathing is fast or difficult, if there is stool, if there is blood in the stools, or when the baby has diarrhea. Then counsel the mother on where and when to take the baby for further immunization. These are the steps taken for transfer and referral of the baby. If the baby needs to be transferred to a 24-hour PHC or first referral unit, ensure that the transfer is safe and timely. It is important to prepare the baby for the transfer, communicate with the receiving facility and provide care during the transfer. Fill up the referral form with the baby's essential information and send it with the baby. Firstly, what will you prepare? Explain to the family the reason for transferring the baby to the higher facility or higher referral system. If possible, transfer the mother with the baby so that she can continue to breastfeed or provide expressed breast milk. You or another healthcare worker should accompany the baby. Ensure that the baby is not exposed to heat or cold. Ask a relative to accompany the baby and mother if possible. The relative may be her husband or mother-in-law or any other person. Care during transfer. Keep the baby in skin-to-skin contact with the mother. If this is not possible, keep the baby dressed and covered and have the mother or relative accompany you. In hot weather, ensure that the baby does not become overheated. Ensure that the baby receives breastfeeds. If the baby cannot be breastfed, give expressed breast milk with a clean spoon or from a cup. Maintain and clear the airway if required. If the baby is receiving oxygen, check the oxygen flow and tubing every 15 minutes. Assess the baby's respiratory rate every 15 minutes. So this is all about postpartum care in community by healthcare providers or healthcare workers. This is the bibliography. Thank you so much. If you will have any query, then you can ask me anytime. Thank you.